Hi you guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, I'm Akanksha. So, finally back with a video. I did film videos previously. This is the new house, by the way. This is the first video we're going to see because it's Valentine's Day. This is the first video I'm going to post. But so we are in the new house. I moved into my new house. There's no setup yet. There are a lot of things I need to do. But for now, this is going to be a background until I figure out something else. And I'm very excited to be in my new house, film in my new house. It's a whole new experience and I'm really excited about it. But so technically this is going to be the first video I post after like my break, and for today's video, because Valentine's Day is around the corner, if you have a boyfriend, don't have a boyfriend, you have a girlfriend, don't have a girlfriend, anything, you can always dress up for your girls, for your boys, whatever it is, and or just for yourself and feel good. So I just thought I'll do like a single look which you can amplify throughout the day, like breakfast date, dinner date, lunch date, like you can go anywhere with just a few changes, and I thought I'll show it to you. So let's get started. So first of all, wash your hair. If you don't wash your hair, I don't know why you would not wash your hair. I personally love washing my hair, especially when there's a special day, because I feel like I really look good like when I freshly wash my hair and blow dry it. If not, you know, that day, the previous day, I just washed my hair last night, so it's kind of fine. So I would not mind going out with this hair, but if you've not washed your hair, then make sure you wash your hair. I mean, that's literally, like, hair can literally amplify anything. You don't even need makeup if your hair looks good. For me, it's like that. If my hair is good, I don't care about makeup most of the times. But yeah, let's get started. So for skin prep, make sure you prep your skin very well if you especially want to go out like throughout the entire day. And don't forget to add your sunscreen. I am not going to add right now because it's literally 6 o'clock in the evening and there is nowhere for me to go and there's not even any sun. But you don't forget to apply. So I just like applied my moisturizer as well. So I'm not going to add anything too much. I'm just going to go in with this Dermaco Squalene Serum, and I'm just going to take like one drop. I don't want to overdo it, but you know, just add it this place because this is the part where I like usually get dry. So only these parts I'm going to add, and under the eyes, so that you know my concealer, powder, etc. won't dry out my under eye. Like, this is not a sponsored video. All the products I'm going to show are products I just want to show, like I think the products which work and I would use. Like if I'm going on a date, I'm not gonna go on a date anywhere. I think that day I'll just sleep, eat and play and not do anything. So next I'm going to go in with this Smashbox primer water. So the first lick we are going to do is for like a breakfast date. I feel breakfast dates are so damn cute. I would really love in the morning just to wear my sweatpants and go for a breakfast date. I mean, that's the most comfortable thing you can do. So that's the reason, you know, I'm going to switch my outfits as well along with the day. So that's the reason I wore a sweatshirt. I would definitely, like, if I'm going on a breakfast date, the first thing, like, so I'm just going to wear my sweatshirt because it's going to be chilly a little bit, and like a pair of good jeans or trousers or something, and just be very comfortable with a slick bag. So you know, that's the vibe we are going for. So I'm going to just, you remember how much I use this in this video, okay? The one dip makeup challenge is going to come. You're going to see my struggle using that. So next I'm going to go in with foundation. Now for breakfast day, the vibe I'm going for is very basic, no makeup look, nothing too strong, nothing too much. It's just like, you know, I've not done a lot of effort but you still want to look good kind of vibe. So the foundations I'm going to use for this is this one, the Maybelline Fit Me foundation and the NYX Can't Stop Won't Stop foundations. I'm absolutely in love with this combination, you guys. This Maybelline, I'm in the shade 310, and NYX I'm in the shade golden, but like golden is way too darker, so if, like, next time I would go for beige. So I'm just taking the foundations. I'm going in with a brush. I'm going to take very light, like you can see one dip. I'm just going to make sure I spread it around. Now your job is to melt this into the skin as seamless as possible. So the areas where I require the maximum coverage is just my cheeks, because I have like a little bit of acne scars there. So I'm just going to make sure I blend these parts as much as I can, and then I'll go on to the rest of the parts and add the coverage if needed. So I have a tissue beside me and I'm just dabbing off the excess products from the brush if I don't really need the excess coverage. So I'm going to just, like, you know, make sure everything is as soft and as skin-like as possible. If you don't have any acne scars, then might as well skip the whole foundation routine, like unless you do want to wear it, then that's fine. But if you don't, then you know, just use a little bit of spot correcting if you have like 1-2 scars, so that it gives a more and more natural finish. Whatever is left on the brush, I'm just going to go over the forehead. I don't usually apply foundation on the forehead because I don't think I need it, and there's no point of adding it there, making it look heavier when it is not required. So see, that is how the skin looks, very very soft, and everything got really nicely covered up. Next, moving on to concealer, I'm using this NARS Creamy Concealer. So it's a tad bit lighter. Like, I would definitely go with this concealer directly if I'm going for a more glam look, but I want this to be like as soft as possible, as like, you know, no effort as possible. So I'm going to take that and I'm just going to pick up a little bit of my foundation as well. I'm going to take, like, mix that and go in so that the shade is not too off and it's kafi like close to my foundation shade. It is definitely a lighter shade, but a shade which is like more manageable. Now, next step, the way to get like the most flawless blend for your concealer is first going in with your my phone doesn't want to stop ringing. It is literally in silent, but it still wants to. I don't know why. So I'm just going to take my ring finger and I'm going to nicely first spread that into the skin, like basically properly even it out. The oils in the finger and the heat of your, like, you know, skin kind of blends products very very beautifully. I don't like to do this for foundation because it's like a large area and I don't want my entire hand to, like, you know, mess up, so I don't do that. But for like concealer, I can just use like one finger under the eye and the job is done. I'm going to go in with the same brush. This is the Real Techniques buffing brush, the foundation I used to apply my foundation, and I'm going to go ahead and blend that with it so that, you know, the color kind of blends into the skin even more. Alright, next, moving on to blush. I'm just going to use blush right now because I want to go in with like a cream blush. And for blush, I'm going in with this Ruby Organics blush. But I want it to look very, very soft. So that's the reason I'm going in with like a cream blush, so that I can properly blend it into my skin and just add like a light touch of color wherever I want. You see such a healthy flush of color, nothing too strong, and it blends into the skin and looks very very beautiful. Quickly, I'm just going to set my under eye before it creases, because nobody wants your concealer to crease. If you want to know how I set my concealer without it creasing, or like tips to help prevent how protect concealer creasing, then definitely watch that video. That video is one of my hit videos. A lot of people found it very very useful. Just add a light touch of powder around like the eyes. Now that we have to wear masks, you just won't want the makeup around like to move. So I just like adding a touch of powder on the entire face, like very very lightly. So yeah, almost done with this look. I just want to add definition to the brows, so I'm just going to go in with this e.l.f. instant lift brow pencil. So I'm just going to lightly brush. I'm not going to do too much. If you have like a brow mascara or like a brow gel, you can definitely just add that instead of like defining it, but I'm just going to tiny bit of like that, and that's it. Now if you really really want to add like something on the lid, then do go ahead, but you know, leaving it bare can sometimes look very very like natural. I'm just going to go in with that foundation brush and like dab on it, just that in case if there's something left, you just cover it up, or else, you know, it's good to go. Or you can add like the same blush, or you can add a little bit of bronzer, or you can just go in with your bronzer, take a little bit, enhance that crease a little more, or add that brown shadow if you wish to. If you don't add the concealer, we naturally have that brown kind of, you know, gradient going on our eyes naturally because of, you know, our skin tone. We already have that. But if you don't you know, really like that, then add a touch of like very very light bit of concealer and like, you know, do your jam. So just adding a touch of bronzer to the forehead, because I like didn't apply anything for the forehead. It looks very very blank. Maybe like a touch on my nose. I can never skip my nose. It's just like I feel so blank without the nose, so I don't apply on the nose. So yeah, that's about it. I'll just add, you can add like a nude lip right now, a very light mascara. Don't go in with mascara which is Wawa Boom, because it just won't look like a very soft thing. Just go with mascara, which is like very, very light. Like this one from Fay Beauty is like a very natural mascara. So you can use this one for like your brows as well and your eyes. Curl my lashes. Like curling would not, you know, damage anything, and it just basically makes your eye look wide open. You can see that instantly, that just curved my eyelashes a lot more. And you can definitely build this up, but I'm going to add just like one layer so that I get like a more natural finish to the lash. Even the, you know, earth rhythm, not earth rhythm, the earth daughter earth pineate lip and cheek tint, apply that. It's very, very like pigmented. I'm just going to first apply that, and I rubbed it off, so it kind of looks like, you know, very naturalist. Like that's what I wanted from that tint. Now I'm going to go ahead and add like a very nice juicy gloss on top of it. So finally, a little bit of setting spray. So I've kept everything very, very, very minimal. I've used the tiniest amount of product as possible. I wanted to keep very, very light, because during the day, the sun haze, there's so much light going on. You can see every single thing on your face. And I did not even add highlighter, if you notice, because highlighter kind of amplifies your look a lot more. But you know, this dewy thing which is going on with the setting spray is like more than enough for a really cute no makeup makeup look, and you don't really need like a highlighter for that. Also, if you want to see like the full outfit of this version, like, you know, breakfast, lunch and dinner, then watch my Instagram reel, which I'll be posting. So let's move on to how we can amplify this look for a lunch date. All right, quick outfit change. A brunch or a lunch calls for a beautiful color dress. Just looks very, very cute. Outfit I'm not going to talk about, because you can check that on Instagram. So if you went on a cute breakfast date and your partner surprised you with a lunch date also, or like if you have multiple men you want to go on multiple dates with, I'm not here to judge. You can cheat how much ever you want. It's your life. I don't know. Who am I to say? Anyways, let's amplify this look a little more. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to first add concealer on my lids, because that just like lifts the look instantly and opens my eyes like a lot more. So first I'm going to go in with the concealer and add that into the lid, because I do want to like add a little bit eyeshadow, top this a little more. Alright, let's add like a little bit of pink, touch of pinks, because I'm wearing pink. If you're wearing any other color, definitely go for that color. Even if you're like, except like if you're wearing like some orange or warm shades, definitely go for pink. It's a very, very flattering color. It just looks beautiful, and you can make it look as soft as you can. So I'm just going in with this LA Girl Pro Artistry, Pro Mastery eyeshadow palette. I'm going to take a mix of this light transition pinks. I'm going to add that in my crease. Don't again want to go very, very heavy-handed, because it's still the daytime. There's a lot of light, especially midnight, like sorry, mid-noon light is not flattering at all. It is so damn strong. So you want to keep it subtle and still, you know, make it add a little more color. Again, of course, like if you are like, if you have the vibe of just wearing purple or red eyeshadow and walking out of the door even during the day, completely fine. If I'm in the mood of that, I would definitely do that. I'm just showing you something which is flattering like universally in a general way, which you can do. So see, touch of pink. Next, I'm going to go in with this shade. I'm going to deepen the crease a little bit. Again, very, very light hand, don't want to go overboard. Feel like the pink did go again a little stronger than how I wish it would. So I'm going to take in these like two really light colors, and I'm blending it out and making it a lot softer. So I'm going to take a tinier brush, and I'm going to go in with the pinks which I used for transition. I'm going to go with the same things under the eye with the same color, but I'm going to now take it on my hand, and I'm going to lightly dab it on. Like, I'm not going for like a cut crease look. Next, we're going to add a little bit of bronzer on our cheeks now to add the more definition. I'm going in with the Hoola bronzer. I'm going to nicely properly bronze my skin. I want that sun-kissed look. I'm going out in the new noon, and I want to look bronzed. Now remember that you did add all these previously, so you just have to like touch up, don't go in with how much you would go initially. And if you do, you know, look like a little oily or a little greasy, then go over with like a light bit of powder and dab that. So next for blush, I'm going in with this K-Beauty blush in the shade Deep Plum, and I'm going to take a very tiny touch of it. Again, not too much, just to, you know, get back the blush. Now of course it's been a couple of hours, you did your makeup, and you know the cream blush kind of must have faded away. This is just to get back that soft touch of color of the blush. Next, now we can add a very little bit of highlighter. Okay, again, don't go overboard. I'm just going to take the Balm Cosmetics highlighter. I'm just going to first spritz my face with the Max Fix Plus or any like setting spray which you want to use. I added a lot. I should not have added so much. So that setting spray dried down. I'm just going to see where light hits, where like a little bit of smile. See, right, for me it's right here. I'm going to just add a touch of this. This is like a very beautiful soft color, like, you know, highlighter. Going in with like the blush brush, and I'm toning down the highlighter a little more. Now when I smile, you get that touch of glow right there, and it looks super cute. Next, I'm going to highlight my nose. Finally, I can highlight my nose, and I'm going to take it right here, add a touch of it there. I'm going to make sure I blend it. I just want like the shadow of the highlighter, and I don't want like the highlighter to actually be seen, like, you know, it is there. It's just like an illusion of something which is glowing and not something which I want to be like seen by the other person. Yay! Now, next, moving on, let's add mascara. Now we can go wah wah boom with our mascara. Do you see the difference? Like, look at this side and this side. Yeah, mascara is on. Time to add a little bit of highlight on the inner corner as well, because I cannot sustain without highlighter in the inner corner. I have to have some shine. Next, moving on to the brow, and so for the base, of course, for people who have really pigmented skin or something, I do have a video of how to get like lighter coverage while you cover the pigmentation as well. I'll link that video here. You can definitely check that one out, like how you can spot conceal stuff and then make everything look a lot flawless rather than adding layers and layers to cover it. So definitely check that one out if you want like a more, you know, get this type of base but you do have pigmentation. So finally, for lipstick, and for lipstick I'm going to go in and add this lipstick. This is the NYX Soft Matte Lip Creme in the shade Prague, and it's like a very hot pink. Just wiped off that gloss a little bit. You can definitely go with a nude, but I'm just like, you know, in the mood with this dress for this beautiful pink. Nice, right? It's been a minute. I used like a hot pink lipstick. Never forget body glow. So I just added a little bit of setting spray, going in with like my highlighter. Especially because I'm wearing like a proper, you know, wide neck, so, you know, this looks very, very beautiful. I apply it in the center, a little, wherever like I have like holes, to just amplify that a little more. So yeah guys, that's it for the lunch or a brunch date look. This looks so pretty, but yeah, I hope you like it. Let's move on to dinner date. All right, lunch date is done. Practically I just had dinner and changed my outfit. Now I want to switch it up like completely to a more bronzy, very like night glam type of look, because I wanted to show you like you can definitely do that even while, you know, if you're like in a pink, you can definitely go bronze as well. I want to get rid of this like very pink hue, because this doesn't suit this dress at all. I'm just going to take like a powder brush. Again, doesn't have anything. If you want, you can take a touch of powder and just like dust on top of it. So don't lift off your makeup, just make sure you dab and remove whatever you want to remove. So next, I'm going to go in with like a more peachier blush. Again, it's from K-Beauty. The shade is Sugar Candy. going to take it and add it on the high point. Like I'm just going to add very, very little because we already have the pink. Just want to tone down the pink a little bit. So I'm going in with this shade, not to like, you know, again, add like an intense amount of brush. So if you really want to get rid of the eyeshadow, you can definitely take a makeup wipe, take like an edge on a corner, put your finger and precisely like, and very gently rub over it and it'll go away. But if you don't want to do it because you might mess up your mascara, whatever it is, you can do what I'm doing. I'm going to show you how to fix this into something more bronzy or more like, you know, warm. So for the eyeshadow palette, I'm going in with the Be Perfect Stacy Marie eyeshadow palette. And first of all, I'm going to take a very beautiful brown because I want to get rid of that pink. So for brown, I'm going to, you know, mix this shade, this like fade and basic. You can definitely go in with you know, your bronzer as well if your eyeshadow is light, but my pink is kind of a little strong, so the bronzer won't do the job as much. So I'm going to go with this. I'm going to add that brown and get rid of that pink. See, it's already very, very muted, the brown. So if you do wipe it off, then you can add concealer and you can definitely go with more stronger color. Now I would, again, same thing what I did previously, I want to keep on the same line, like a light brown transition and a deeper brown on the edge to get more definition. So I'm going in with the haul. This is like a very deep brown shade. I'm going to add that on the edge and again blend it in. See, you can definitely amplify any look. That's actually the point why like I made this video, is that you don't have to like do a different thing for every look. You can simply amplify what you have, play around with it, see where it goes. If you are really afraid to do it while you're going out because you don't want to test it, you can do it when you're sitting at home or you return from some place and you have nothing else to do. You can, you know, do such things so that you understand what suits your face a lot better. So I'm going to go in with this darker color. This is the shade Intuition. I'm going to mix a little bit of black. I'm going to line my lid. You can definitely use like an eyeliner or like a kajal to do this, but I usually go in with eyeshadow because it's like a lot simpler and easier. If you want like an intense pigment, then go in with like a liner. I just want like that smoky effect. And applying liner after you apply mascara can be a little tricky as well, so be like very careful if you do apply liner after you apply your mascara. Now next, definitely in the night I would never really forget to do a good like foxy eye. Now finally, for like highlighter, now you can go ham with your highlighter nighttime with the lights and all. It just really, really nicely glows. Again, going ahead and adding that inner corner highlight as well. Now, finally, a really good night look would definitely mean like a red lip, or you can definitely go with a nude. Again, it's a personal choice. So I'm just using the Faces Canada Ultimate Intense Matte Lipstick in the shade Blood Moon. It's a very beautiful like maroonish red. See, that red lip like just amplified everything. The red lip just does that magic. And this is one of the shades I really, really like. Now, you can definitely add lashes to make this more glam. So I'm going to do that because lashes just turn up the whole look. I'll just do that and I'll be right back with the finished look. So yeah guys, that's it. That is the finished look. Now there are a couple of things I want to touch on if in case you do face that issues when you're doing, you know, such type of like transformation from one look to the other, is of course oily skin people would tend to get very, very oily during the day. So I would definitely recommend you to watch one of my videos which I did for oily skin, so you can do that before you start your makeup. And even if you get oily throughout the day, just take like a sponge or a brush, go into the powder and touch up wherever you think you're getting oily. And sometimes if you do feel like you need a little more coverage in certain areas which you've skipped previously to get like a more like no makeup look, if you have a powder foundation, you can definitely go over on top of that part and then, you know, fix that thing. So yeah, I think with that we complete this look. It was a very random thought I got, like why not show it to you. It might be useful for you if you want to shift from one look to the other. And that's it for this video. I hope you liked all the three looks. I hope this video was very, very useful. If you liked the video and if you enjoyed what I did, then make sure you like, share, and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell. And don't forget forget to check the outfits on Instagram Reels. I'll definitely be posting there, like the outfits, whatever I'm wearing right now. And yeah, if you want to add body glow, then you definitely can go ahead and do that. But that's it for this video. I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.